Hey, good morning, everyone. Today I would like to. Can you also give me the admin so I can share my screen? Today I would like to talk and then share with you guys regarding our calendar and the names in our calendar and where it comes from, what's the history behind. And then also we can start the Avesta for Berasot, which is talking about mentioning regarding all the names of the month. So let's start first regarding the calendar. What is our calendar? Why our calendar is different even from the rest of Iranian calendar? What's very specific about Zoroastrian calendar? So Zartoshi calendar is which later on has been changed to the solar calendar. However, in the very beginning, it had 30 names. Those 30 names is start with those six Amshaspand names, which last time I covered what are those Amshaspand names, like Vahman, Ardibehesht, and all those ones. And also the name of Yazet or Izad, or those one that from Mithraism, we are believing that those were like a different god. So within those 30 days, which our calendar is based on the month and 30 days in Zartoshti calendar, and later on followed by solar system. However, when you are thinking about every month having a 30 names or 30 days, then you are saying 30 times 12 become 360. What about 365 days plus 4 hours? The last 5 days, which we are calling it Panje, and that is gonna come for those five section of Gatas, which I'm gonna cover later on. And then those 4 hours or the 6 hours extra, every 4 years are going to be a leap year, which now we are calling a different name like Avardhan. But again, as you can imagine, in the very beginning, Zartoshi's calendar didn't have these 31 days and didn't exactly follow the solar system. So what happened? So it started with a calendar in Sasanian, but then later on, those people that moved to India and then they escaped because of all those Arab invasion and everything. So they kept this Kadimi calendar or old calendar, but they didn't update themselves based on the changes that happened in Iran. Therefore, they are currently are off from the current Zoroastrian calendar. Later on, they came back and then by Parsi people, they created another one. It's called Shahanshahi or royal one. And still that one also has some missing. Which what it happens now, if you ever talking to some of those Zoroastrian or Parsi people who are following Kadimi calendar or ancient calendar, which is goes back for 632 from the Christianity time frame or era, they are celebrating their new year in the middle of the June, almost like a 22, 21 of July. Not June, sorry, July. They're celebrating in the middle or toward end of July. That's their New Year or Nowruz. Even though that Shahanshahi or imperial calendar also came to fix it, what Parsi left off, and then they introduced this 365 calendar with the leap year and everything, still they are also very off from the most recent Fasli or seasonal calendar that now Zoroastrian follow. So based on Shahanshahi, which a very small percentage of Parsi people follow that, they are celebrating the Nowruz in 21 August, almost like a 1 month after that Kadimi. But today, most of our Zoroastrian all around the world, we are following Fasli seasonal, or we are calling it Bostani calendar. And this is very much based on a solar system. And our Nowruz is 2021 of the March, depends on the leap year and everything. But how it's created? So if I want to simplify this Fastly calendar in few bullets, this is it. Every month in our Fastly calendar has 30 days and it has 30 names. But because one solar year has 12 months and 5 days and 6 hours, so the last 5 days of the year has been called Panji, and they're going to be named after those five gatas, which is Ahnavat, Oshtavat, Spentamat, Vahukhoshat, and Vahishtuash. This 6 hours a year, that is not calculated. However, every 4 years when it becomes one day, then this one day we are calling it Avardot, and that's the extra day. So that's the difference if I'm putting in comparison for our Iranian and also for those people following the Gregorian calendar, which is this Christianity calendar. That's the difference. So Zartoshi month is Farvardin, is only had 30 days, but the real solar Iranian calendar has 31 days. In fact, the first 6 months of Iranian is always 31 days. The next 5 months is 30 days. And then the very last one is 29 days. That's what it been created as a solar system. But we are sticking with the name of each day in a month, and we only have 30 names. So it doesn't matter what is in the beginning or middle. We always carry this 30 days. So that's why at some point we are going to be mismatched starting from the second month because of this 1 month difference. But when we are sticking with the 30 days, as I mentioned, 30 times 12 become 360, the last 5 days Panje, which in reality in our ancient or ancestor, they were dedicating those 5 days for cleaning their house, which is part of our culture, to make sure we are cleaning our house from all the clutter, from the dust and everything. That was the Panje. And at some point also, we were celebrating it for to welcome, what do you guys call it, the soul of those dead people, whoever were loved, the one that was passed away on that day, on that year. So somehow we are cleaning it and then dusting away, so make sure that we are welcoming them back again to our home and family. But then again, every 4 years, it's going to be one extra day is going to be added as an avardot, or we are calling it in Farsi kabise. When you're comparing with the Gregorian month, pretty much our month, it's sitting between two different months. So the new year of Nowruz is started with March 21st. It's going to go all the way till April. And April 20th is going to be the next month. So that is a difference between three different calendar. So if you ever, anyone is asking why Zartoshi calendar is different from Iranian calendar, don't you think that you guys are Iranian or the origin of your calendar or your people, it started in Iran? Yes, it started, but we have names for each of our day versus Iranian, they don't. They're just calling it 1st of Farvardin, 5th of Farvardin. So then your question is that how does it look like? So if everyone in our Zartoshti, even here, we are still carrying, I'm minimizing it so you guys can see it. We are having something like that calendar, which is hanged over the wall next to our kitchen or something. So we are aware of what day, what particular day is that. Why? Because some of those day has a very specific meaning to us. Let's say that this was back in 2012, the March, which March 20th, it was the Nowruz. So if, as you can see it, it has the number of the day based on Iranian calendar. So Farvardin, the first Farvardin, second Farvardin, third Farvardin, all the way to 31st Farvardin. One is going to start with Zartoshti calendar. And then the bottom, of course, it has this Gregorian calendar or Christianity time, which is March 20th. And it shows on the top. But if you are seeing it beneath that, it has a name, and it started with the Shesh Amshaspan, Urmazd, Vahman, Ardibehesh, Shahrivar, Spendarmazd, Khordad, Amordad. Then the rest of those names either is Yazeta or Izat, which it contains the name of our particular month as well. So you're seeing some of those color code I put it. So let me go with the rest of them. I'm going to make highlight and mention it. Then I'm going to come back. Then we have Deva Azar, Azar, Aban, Khair or Khor, Ma, Tir, Goosh, Deva Mehr, Mehr, Surush, Rashn, Farvardin, Virahram, Ram, Dad, Deibedin, Din, Ard, Ashtad, Asman, Zamyad, Spend, Anaram. Then again, it's going to start with Urmaz because we only have 30 names. So this name is being repeated. And it's always in the same order. It's always goes in the same thing. So you never can say Deve Mehr, then it comes Bad. It's Deve Mehr, then it becomes Mehr. Those names that you can see it is being highlighted more in orangish. More or less, this is exactly the name of Ahura Mazda, which we have as part of 101 names for Ahura Mazda. Urmazd, and the rest is start with Dei. Dei be Azar, Dei be Mehr, Dei be Din. Then we have those other 4 days that you're seeing more in yellowish, which those are the one, if you remember, the first Amsha spent, which is exactly Vahman or Vuhuman, for the sake of protecting animal. And in our ancestor, they made sure that they are on that day, they're not hunting, they're not killing. So there is no blood of that animal are going to be wasted. So those one at the same time, they were so wise and bright, somehow they tried to balance out those population of animal at the same time. So they were preventing of that extra killing or something. So it was not only one day, they added more days. So all these 4 days in yellow, today, since we are not hunting anymore, at least we are respecting and we are not eating meat. But then in old time, they were not killing animals. So now Vahman, Ma, Gush, Ram, those 4 days are the one that we are not eating meat. Because there are sometimes people are coming and asking me, say, oh, is this your religion also has some fasting? I said, well, no, we don't have fasting. Oh, so you don't have those 1 month fasting? I said, no, we don't have fasting, quote unquote, the way that Muslim people do. But we do respect animals. And because of that, 4 days, we are not eating meat. Can it be any 4 days? Yeah, if you want, it can be any 4 days, but whoever is following this calendar and they're respecting our religion, it has to be those particular 4 days that we are not eating meat. Even though if we are celebrating some of our events, Sade, Mirgon, if it happens to be in any of these days, you will see that the community or the organizer are definitely providing a non-meat food. Or kind of like a vegetarian one. Okay, so then you're saying it, I got it. Can you one more time tell me what it looks like? So this is the 30 days of the month that I put it together. And now instead of for you guys that needs to see in English version, that's why I put it over here. The first 6, these are all about of course, the first is Urmazd. Sometimes that's why people are saying it half the Amshaspan, which is not half. But that's why Urmazd is always coming number one. And then these are the 6 Amshaspan. So Urmazd, Vahman, Ardibehesh, Shahrivar, Spendarmazd, Khordad, Amordad, which Khordad can be Hovartad and Amartad. So that's why you are seeing this color coded of this. I should say violet or purple. those green one, and it's always going to be like that. The first day of the month, the 8th, the 15th, and 23rd. It's always going to be the same name. Urmas, Deybe Azar, Deybe Mehr, and Deybe Din. And these are exactly the name of the God, which is exactly the meaning is a creator, and is part of this 101 names. Those yellow one are the name that we are not eating meat. So is Vahman, Ma, Gush, and Ram. But the rest is all about Izadan, or in fact, is the name of the month is there. And you said, what do you mean the name of month is there? So if you're looking at one, we have Ardibehesht. If the month of Iranian Ardibehesht with Ardibehesht is falling, we are calling it Ardibehesht gone. And in our ancient time, they were celebrating it. Then you said, if that's the case, we should have 12 celebration. Yes, in the past, every month they were celebrating it. And then remember, that's why we are saying Zoroastrianism is a religion of happiness and then celebration. We are having more happiness and gathering rather than mourning and then sorrowing. So they had these 12 different celebration, which every month depends on the name of the month, and the name of the day was just falling on each other. Meh becomes Mehrgan, Tir becomes Tirgan, and that's where you exactly can find. So Ardibeheshtgan, Shahrivargan, Spandarmaz, your Espandgan, Hordadgan, Amordadgan, Abangan, Tirgan, Mehrgan, Farvardingan, and that's exactly this 19th. The Farvardingan is a celebration for going back to the cemetery and then bringing the Nowruz to our dead people. We are not going to mourn for them. We are not going to sit and cry. We are all saying it. This year you was missed in our family. So instead, we are coming to you and bringing this Hafsin and Nowruz to you guys. So kind of just remembering them. And that's Farvardingan. Then that's it. So if you're counting all those one that I mentioned, that's the 12. But now from those days until now, only a few that we are continue celebrating, which is still stick with part of our culture. We are celebrating Farvardingan, which I mentioned regarding of celebrating the Nowruz for our dead ones. Tirgan, which is a celebration of water. Then we are kind of like throwing water to each everyness. That's the best thing during a very hot days in the middle of the summer. That's Tirgan. Then next, Shahrivargan, which we are celebrating for Men's Day, supreme in power. Mehrgan is reality, is like a autumn festival. It is like celebration of going into the fall and autumn. And then at that time, all those farmers and our ancestors, they were sharing the outcome of their agriculture to make sure no one is going to feel hunger. That's Mehrgan. And then from anything else, if I can think about it, then it's going to go all the way to Esfandgan or Sepandarmizdgan, which is the Women Day or Ruzezan. Now, in between, we also have another celebration, which is Jashn Sadeh. And that is going to go based on 100 days passed from that the big winter, and then 50 days left before going into the Nowruz, 50 days and 50 nights that it becomes again 100, and 100 means like a Sadeh, but that has nothing to do with this gone. So only if you are thinking about like 4 or 5 that nowadays we are celebrating, when the name of the month and the name of the day is going to be falling into the same things, so we are celebrating that day. Do you guys have any question for me? Okay. Let's go per our custom. Let's go ahead and then first pray Hashem Bohu Yato Ahu. Then I'm going to go to Berasot. I'm going to explain how it's been categorized and how now you can recite that Berasot. It's not that you need to memorize it because now you know the logic behind. And then we can also listen to our track. So let's first go ahead with these two small prayers. Hashem Bohu Aishem Asi Ushta Asi Ushta Mai Head Ashoi Vaishoi Hashem Yatahu Vairyo Atoratosh Ashau chit hacha Vangheosh dazam nangho Shiaut nanam angheosh mazdai Shatrim chauraya Im dregubiu dadadvastarem. Okay. Let's go all the way to Berasot. Okay. I'm going to first recite the first section, but I'm going to cover the next and then you guys can see it. So Berasot is all about make sure that our voice, our prayer are going to be heard by Ahura Mazda. And then he will accept, he will listen. And that's exactly, it's very, very Farsi. But then I'm going to make sure that you guys are Berasot, it means be received. Bepazirat, it means accepted. Bin yushad, it means is been heard. Dadar urmes. So we are praying and making sure our prayers has been received, accepted, and heard. And then, of course, normally as a human, we are always asking God, oh, how about this one? How about that one? So we want to make sure all of our wishes also is going to be heard by Ahura Mazda. But that's not the intention. So Berasado, Bepazirado, Benyushad, Dadar, Urmaz. Pasande Yazdan Bad, Hayaraye, Vahan Rasad. Bechoshnudiye, Mainuye, Dadar, Urmazde, Rayumande, Kharumand. Now from here, you're seeing it. I'm highlighting some of these words and the rest of them is going to come after. It starts with those amshaspand. So first urmaz, and then the rest of these six amshaspand is going to be followed through this berasot. So bechoshnudiye mainuye urmaz abogohe صده ویس بی شام به خوشنودی مینوی وحمن. If you remember, that was the first one, وحمن. But the rest is covering because they're all in the same category for protecting animal and not eating meat. That's why we have وحمن و ماه و گوش و رام. به خوشنودی مینوی اردی بهشت, that's the second امشاسپن. اردی بهشت بلند و آذر و سروش و ورهرام. If you remember, اردی بهشت was the second امشاسپن. That was all about fire, truth and righteousness. And that's why everything in the category of that is going to come and then become in this one. Which Azar is another meaning for Atash. Bechoshnudiye mainuye shahrivaro دست ترد امشاسپند، شهریور و خور و مهر و آسمان و انارام، انقر روشنگاه خدا. شهریور was a supreme in power and also was sky, a representing of the element or the creations of God, which was sky, and making sure as a human we are not polluting and protecting and everything. Therefore, Khor or Khorshid, Meh, and Osman sky, they're all going to be fall into that Shahrivar. Again, these are all meaning for that supreme in power somehow. Sometime with Khor in Zartoshi, we are saying Khair also, Khairize. به خوشنودی منوی سپندار مزد و آبان و دین و ارد و مانتر سپند. سپندار مزد, that was the fourth one. It was about earth, fate, and the rest of them are going to be in this group. به خوشنودی منوی خرداد و کشتر و باد و فروردین. And then the sixth امشاسپند, به خوشنودی مینوی امرداد و رشن و اشتاد و زامیاد. Now from here we are going to cover the rest of those calendar as we said. First we are going to touch about those five gah, which was a five different period of the time that we can pray. به خوشنودی مینوی هاون و رپیدون و اوزیرن و ایویس روترم و اوشهنگاه باد. Here we are talking about those 5 days of the end of the year, which was related for the five gathas. In another sense, we were calling it panje, or those 5 days that we were supposed to clean our house and everything. به خوشنودی مینوی گاه گاتابیو احنود اشتود سپنتمد وحوخ شطر و هشتوش باد. Here they are talking about some of those ایزدان or یزد. به خوشنودی مینوی هومیزد برزیزد نیرو سنگیزد دهمان و وهان و آفرینیزد باد. به خوشنودی مینوی گاه گاهان بار. These are different Gahambar or Gahambar. If you remember, I've been also mentioning that in Zoroastrian, we have in fact six Thanksgiving, six festivals that we are making sure that all of our community are still together. No one feels hunger. No one feels out of food. Depends on that, the hard time or that year that somehow they didn't have enough corp and everything. So therefore we have six different Gahambar we are celebrating, and nowadays pretty much we are just making some small food and still spreading it among the rest of the community. But that's exactly now is mentioning it. What are the name of those six Gahambar or Gahambar? به خوشنودی مینوی گاه گاهانبار میدیو زرمگاه میدیو شمگاه پیتا شهمگاه ایا سرمگاه میدیارمگاه همسپت میدیمگاه باد. And then here we go. Now we are going to look at our calendar. What's the name of this day? What gah and what month we are praying it? And making sure that our prayers are going to be received, accepted, and heard by Ahura Mazda. به خوشنودی امروز روز پیروز و فرخ روز. Let's say today is a تیر ایزد. We say تیر ماه خجسته ماه. And now here we are in the month of شهریور. گاه it's in the morning is nine-ish and that is going to be هاون. هاون برساد پسند و پذیرفته دادار اورمزد باد. کامه باد ایدون باد ایدون ترج باد. اشم و هو و اشتم استی اوشتا استی اوشتا احمای هیدشایی و اشتای اشم. The meaning of everything is in the next two pages, which you guys can definitely follow. Actually, in one page. All those meanings in one page. So I can stop sharing, and then if Artemis John, you can go ahead and then put.
به خوشنودی مینوی دادار اورمزد رای و مند خرومند. به خوشنودی مینوی اورمزد اواگاه سده ویس پیشان. به خوشنودی مینوی بهمن و ماه و گوش و ران. به خوشنودی مینوی اردی بهشت بلند و آدر و سروش و برهران. به خوشنودی مینوی شهریور و خور و مهر و آسمان و انارام انقر روشن گاه خدا. به خوشنودی مینوی سپندار مزد و آبان و دین و ارد و مانت رسپند. به خوشنودی مینوی خرداد و تشتر و باد و فروردین. به خوشنودی مینوی امرداد و رشن و اشتاد و زامیاد. به خوشنودی مینوی هاون و رپید و نو زیرن و ایویس رو ترم و شهنگاه باد. به خوشنودی مینوی گاه گاتا بیو احنوت اشتوت سپنتمت و هوخشت و هشتوش باد. به خوشنودی مینوی هومیزد برزیزد نیرو سنگیزد دهمان و وهان و آفرینیزد باد. به خوشنودی مینوی گاه گاهن بار میدیو زرمگا میدیو شمگا پایت شمگا ایاس رمگا میدیا رمگا همسپت میدیم گا با. به خوشنودی امروز روز فیروز و فرخ روز ماه خجسته ماه گاه برساد پسند و پذیرفته دادار اورمزد باد. کامه باد ایدون باد ایدون ترج باد اشم و هو و هیشت مستی اوشتا استی اوشتا احمایی هیت اشایی و هیشتایی اشم
Thanks, Artemis. Since now we still have time, if we are okay, let me share and then we can also finish Avestaye Tandorosti, which is the prayer for the good health. And I think that is very simple yet for, I should say, for Farsi language people, of course. For non-Farsi people can be difficult. But then I'm going to make sure that very slowly I'm going to read that Avesta. Again, this prayer is all about requesting a good health. And then it's all about health that is the precious things. It was one idiom or one sentence in an article they were saying it. Health, once you have it, you don't appreciate it, or you're not thinking that what you have. Once you're losing it, you're crying to come back. But that looks like a bird that flew away from the cage. Once it flew away, it's hard to bring it back. So once health is gone, it's gone. So we definitely need to appreciate for our health, for our tandorosti. So I'm going to slowly reading it, but then to be honest, the meaning is very straightforward, and it has also the next page regarding the meaning of that. Urmazd panah bad, dir zivishni shad bad, yatahu vairyu ataratosh ashachi tacha, vangiosh dazda menango. شیعوت ننام انکهوش مزدائی شطرم چا اورایا ایم درگو بیوددد واسطارم تندرستی دیر زیوشنی عواید خرننگ هد اشویه دار یزدان مینوان و یزدان گیتیان و امشاسپندان میزد روشن هما برساد این دودمان شاد باد آفرین باد همه اندر کسان را زرتشت دین شاد باد ایدون باد خواهان باد اورمزد خدا را همه انجمن را دین زرتشتی را همه بهدینان را One thing I have to explain بهدینان And it's very common that we are using it for our community members who are following Zoroastrianism and they are part of the Zarathustra religion. But at the same time that we are calling it Behdin Nushin, Behdin Artemis, Behdin Aryan, at the same time, what we are claiming it that this is the best religion. That kind of like a dual meaning that we are using it. So Behdinan, whoever is a follower of Zartosh, and yet we believe they are the best religion followers. Tandorosti nik nami, tandorosti zindegani, tandorosti farakh ruzi, tandorosti shadi o rameshni, Tandorosti tane. Here we are saying it, I'm praying for the health for the body of whoever that you want to mention, the body of نوشین with her family. تندرستی تنه it means that the health for the body of someone. را با means and with whoever that you want to mention, the family, the team member, I don't know, colleague, mom, dad. زندگانی دراز باد. Again, this is very Farsi. For Farsi people, they are clearly can understand, but then we are saying it. Hope it has a very long life. زندگانی دراز باد. دیر بدار. شاد بدار. تندرست بدار. ایدون بدار. بر سر ارزانیان بدار. سالهای بسیار، روزهای بیشمار، جاوید و پاینده بدار. One thing that is very interesting, and I'm going to repeat one more time, so listen to this section. First is going to say with سال, it means year. Then is going to go with روز, it means day. One more time is emphasizing. صد هزاران هزار آفرین باد. First, سال خجسته باد. روز فرخ باد. ماه فرخنده باد. First is mentioning about year, then day, then month. Isn't that exactly how we are putting in our calendar when we are writing it down? That's exactly how we are saying it. We are coming with the year, then we are going to come with the day and the month. And that's exactly what is following here. چندین سال, چندین روز, چندین ماه. بسیار سال ارزانی دار. یزشنو نیایش رادیو زورو برشنه اشویی دار. ابرهما کارو کرفها تندرستی باد رادی باد نیکی باد خوبی باد ایدون باد ایدون ترج باد. پرمزد و امشاز پندان کامه باد. اشون اشم رو و اشتمستی اوش را استی اوش را احمایی خید اشایی و اشتایی اشم. And the meaning, it doesn't have a meaning here, but I think it was very Farsi for Farsi people, but probably I can find the English one for you guys. Is there any question for me? I'm going to unshare, and then if you guys have any question, let me know. Otherwise, we can finish our session a few minutes earlier.
Thank you so much, Nushinjan, for putting this time and teaching us how to say the common prayers. We really appreciate your time.
Thank you so much. Yes. Thank you, Arian, and everyone.
Thank you. See you next time. Bye, everyone.
Bye.
Thank you, Ash. Thank you, Arian. Thank you. Bye-bye.